Hey there, Taurus. Welcome to your reading for the first quarter of 2021. This is going to be a reading for the next 3 months, and we're just going to take a look and see what comes up for you with this main spread. And then we're going to clarify at the end with the Lenormand, and we're going to see if there's any extra advice, anything else that you could be doing here, Taurus, in this first quarter to make it a much more successful year. But let's see what is going on for you here. I really feel like there's a need. I am going to take this card right here. I feel like the King of Wands is an answer to this last row. So we're definitely going to talk about that. But I do feel that there is a need for you to not give up on something here, Taurus, in the first quarter of the year. I feel like there could be something that you're working on. This is like something you're dreaming of. Something needs to be healed here as well for you to accomplish whatever this goal is. It's coming in very strong as well here, Taurus. So I will say that. Also, Taurus, make sure to watch your sun, moon, rising for a full picture of what's going on for you over these next 3 months. You're the first sign that does not have the tower. So I don't know what is going on. You have the Ten of Swords here. You know, Ten of Swords energy is very similar, but we'll talk about that in a minute. Again, I feel like this is more saying don't give up on something, which we're going to talk about in a minute. You have this A Merry Motive card. I feel like you could be kicking off the year very motivated, which I feel like happens to a lot of people, not just you, Taurus. You have a lot of good energy here as well, but then you go to the Five of Wands. It's kind of like all those like what ifs and things like that start creeping into your head. I feel like it will be very important for you to kind of, you know, kind of keep your goals a little bit close to the chest at the beginning of this year. I would be careful who you share things with, you know, not because it's not a good idea to share, but I feel more because, you know, I feel like you just shouldn't have people, you know, hating on your ideas and things like that with the Five of Wands. I say this because number one, I feel like I said something very similar in your 2021 reading. But number two, I feel like there is a need for you to kind of like work on something like a goal or something you want to achieve with this Imagine card. This Imagine card has a person who is pulling the moon down to earth. And in the Lenormand, to me, the moon in the Lenormand represents needing to pull the moon down to earth, needing to manifest one of your dreams in reality. You have the moon right here as well. So I do feel that there's a need to get working. But again, I feel like if you have people who, you know, just can't see your vision, then, you know, that could be causing a lot of problems. You have the Nine of Pentacles, the Queen of Wands, and the Five of Wands. Very motivated. Nine of Pentacles, like pre-Empress energy, and you know she's a minor arcana version of the Empress. And you have the Queen of Wands. The Queen of Wands, to me, is a very bold, very assertive energy. You get this card quite a bit. And I'm always saying to you, Taurus, that I feel for you, your best bet for success is to be very bold, be very assertive, and really go for things. You even have the Strength card here. It's like if I, you know, what I'm noticing is this here, Taurus, is this right here. Like these, you know, these five cards, like making this C right here, this like backwards shaped C with the Strength card in the middle. It's almost like there are like a million reasons why something can't be accomplished right here, you know, in all these cards. But the Strength card is a card of accomplishing something despite your circumstances, no matter what is happening to you. The Strength card, like, you know, I always say, to me, the Strength card is a display of strength. She has her hands in a lion's mouth, and it kind of is a display of strength. It's like, who in their right mind would stick their hands in a lion's mouth? The answer is nobody, for the most part. But, you know, really, it's a display of strength. So we're going to talk about that more in a minute. But over here, I feel like you're very attractive at this time as well. So if you are looking for love, I would get out there. You always have Leo showing up in your readings. So it could be a Leo. Could also be a Pisces. You have Pisces here, and it could be any sign, really. I mean, it's just a general reading. But I do feel like you're very attractive at this time. Next, you have the Healing Chaos card. Again, I feel like there are things that need to be smoothed over is what's popping into my head here. I do feel that there are certain restrictions that you're trying to work around with this Healing Chaos card as well. Like maybe you want to start a business, but maybe you don't have the money or the resources. Maybe you want to get into a relationship, but there's COVID and, you know, a million other things going on that are probably preventing that. So I feel like, again, I feel like there are plenty of reasons why that, you know, you can't have what you want at this time. But you have the Moon, the Strength card, and the Nine of Swords. The Nine of Swords really reminds us that our circumstances are temporary. Nine of Swords is a card of, you know, having a nightmare, and this person on this card is having a nightmare. They're waking up and they're still stuck in a nightmare. So it's kind of like a card of being in a nightmare and waking up and being stuck in a nightmare. But really, the Nine of Swords, again, reminds us that these situations are just temporary in a lot of ways. You also have the Strength card, which says you will definitely get through anything that you're going through. And on top of that, I feel like there are a lot of reasons here, like I said, and there are going to be solutions, by the way, Taurus. Again, as I always say, my readings are solutions based. My readings are not like, oh, your life is, you know, your life is shit and you're screwed, you know, which I feel like some readers do. And, you know, actually not very many on YouTube, but for the most part, I would say that my readings are more solution based. So yeah, you might be going through it, but I feel like there will be solutions here when we clarify. So keep that in mind. But also, I feel like you could be showing off at this time with the Strength card, and you need to show off. The Strength card is like doing something, again, in the face of adversity, and I feel like some of you need to do that. Definitely, this has the vibes of needing to not give up. Like, I'm pretty surprised that the Nine of Wands didn't come up here. The Moon even says you need to keep going. The Moon is part of the Fool's journey. And, you know, the Moon to me does not say stop. It is, again, part of the Fool's journey. It's like we have to get past the Moon. We don't just stop here. So I feel for some of you, again, it could be a little chaotic at this time. For some of you, again, I don't, you know, this isn't, you know, as I always say, this is not soap opera tarot, right? It's like, you know, I feel like, you know, maybe just some of you have some minor obstacles that you're trying to overcome over these next 3 months. And the Moon says keep pushing, keep going, because on the other side of pain is success. I have a million things popping in my head right now, Taurus. Like, when you're going through hell, keep going. Like, all those sayings are popping into my head right now. So I really feel this is like a reading that says, do not give up. Why? Because there's something that you desire. You have the Imagine card. This card says that there are things that you're dreaming of having, or that you dream of manifesting in your life. And this card says you can have it. There's a person here. It's going to be really hard to see, but there's a person here with a rope going up to this moon here on this card. And this card says, like, you need to manifest your dreams in reality. I feel really there is a connection between the two cards. Again, the Moon is a card of going through darkness. The Moon, to me personally, is a good card. The Moon in the tarot represents a period after a full moon, and it represents a period of like innovation, of trying new things, doing things you've never done before. That's really why the card represents fear, because it's like you're just doing something new. You're just doing something, or you're on a new path. You're starting a new journey. You're going to places you've never been before. And so again, that's not a bad thing. That's a good thing. You have the Ten of Swords, the Five of Pentacles, and the Two of Cups here. Definitely feel like people can help you at this time with the Two of Cups. The Two of Cups is a perfect match. It is also a card of you and your higher self as well. So a lot of you could be very much tapping into your inner strength over the next 3 months. The Ten of Swords is definitely something being dead done over with, but the Ten of Swords is actually a card of luck as well. He's making the symbol with his hand right here on the Ten of Swords. And I mean, you can say how bad of a card the Ten of Swords is. It's a card of victimhood. It's a card of being stabbed in the back. It's a card of death. It's a card of something being dead done over with as well. It's a card of total completion. But it's also a card of like luck as well. It's kind of a card that says, it's like, okay, something is dead, but it's like, you can't just lay there. Like, this guy, he needs to realize that he's dead. He needs to move on. So for some of you, I feel like this is saying that it's like, there's a whole new world coming in for you. There's something new that's coming in. I really feel like you have a choice between these two cards right here. The Strength card is using words of strength. The Five of Pentacles is calling attention to your weaknesses. This guy right here represents a leper, and he has a belt around his neck. And, you know, back in the day, lepers had to wear bells so people knew when they were coming down the street. And basically, the Five of Pentacles can be a card of victimhood, you know, all of these other things. But it also says, do not call attention to your weaknesses. I feel like your words are going to be very important over these next few months here, Taurus. So I would definitely keep it positive. Having said all that, you know, I'm getting chills right now thinking about this right here. I really feel like this is your solution to pretty much everything. The King of Wands is a card of really nurturing something, really taking care of something. I always say, to me, he is the true father in the tarot. He like nurtures things into existence. He kind of takes something and raises it like a baby. Could be a business idea here. It could be a new relationship for you as well, Taurus. But I feel like if you do that, you will be very successful. He is also protected from risk as well. He has these salamanders all over his cloak, and in mythology, salamanders could not be burnt by fire. So I feel for a lot of you, this is actually saying you are kind of like protected at this time. So this looks like a little bit challenging, but I would also say it's really not. You know, again, I feel like mostly a couple of mental challenges here, needing to keep your words positive, but overall very attractive at this time. Like I said, could be attracting love as well, which we're going to dig into that right now. So thank you for being here, Taurus. Really appreciate it. Make sure to drop a like on this video. Really appreciate all the likes and all the support. But Taurus, let's see here what wants to come up. You have the 10 of Hearts here, which is called the Dog. You have the 6 of Diamonds, Just Do It. And the 6 of Diamonds to me is a card called the Clover. You always get this card. Taurus, literally, go back to the beginning of my channel, like 6 years ago, and you used to get this card all the time. I used to only read playing cards, and you always used to get the 6 of Diamonds. And the 5 of Spades, Take a Risk. I do feel like it is time for you to kind of like take a risk to step out into the world. The 10 of Hearts is a card of loyalty. So if you're looking for love, it can represent loyalty. It can represent someone who will be loyal to you. It's just an amazing love card. The 6 of Diamonds coming up between the Queen of Wands and the Strength card is hilarious to me. The 6 of Diamonds is called the Clover, and it represents like a 4-leaf clover. It's a very lucky card, but it also is the card of imposter syndrome, which again, since the beginning of my channel, you have been getting this card all the time. So it's a card that says you need to be Queen of Wands. You need to embrace the energy of being bold, being assertive. I really feel like if you just act as if you already have something, or if you just act as if you already are something, then you will have it. So, you know, again, I feel like a lot of you, and this has come up for you in the past year, Taurus, I feel like a lot of you are learning like how to step into an energy. Like maybe there's a certain job you want, and it's like maybe people who have that job have a certain energy. Maybe there's a certain person you want to date. It's like maybe that certain person has a certain energy. It's like I feel like you're learning how to step into those energies. You're not changing. I don't think you're becoming a different person. I feel like you're just learning how to step into the energy. It's just that simple. And I feel like this is a good thing. The 5 of Wands and this 9 of Swords, you have this 5 of Spades here. 5 of Spades is not a real Norman card. It's just a playing card. And again, to me, it is a breakup. So some of you definitely could be going through like a difficult separation here. I almost feel like you're saying, like you're separating from something though. It's like I feel like you're having to let something go here with this 5 of Spades. Kind of like a weird feeling. It's almost like maybe you're having to like let go of some money or something like that. Or like, I feel like you've already had to do this with that 5 of Spades, but I feel like everything is going to work out. You have the 3 of Spades here. Definitely could be a breakup. 3 of Spades is just a breakup here. And it's like, you're not sure what you are going to do. You have the 3 of Clubs, second chances. 3 of Clubs is a card of second chances. And the 5 of Hearts, new love. So if you went through a difficult breakup recently, this could definitely be new love coming in for you. It would not surprise me if it was a fire sign with that King of Wands there. You always get fire in your readings, and so I do feel like a lot of you could be dealing with a fire sign. Now for others, I feel like you could have gone through a breakup. Maybe you thought you were going to marry a person with this 10 of Wands or the 10 of Hearts. Maybe you thought there was a deep connection, and maybe the moon is like confusion because it's like, maybe you thought you were going to be with this person forever. It's like, there is a little, I do get like a little bit of a shake up energy here. Even though you do have the Healing Chaos card, which is a card healing that chaos, you know, I feel like for some of you, it's almost like your worldview has been disturbed. It's like what you thought was true is not. And I feel like that has kind of cause some, you know, kind of some shakeups here. Let's put it that way. You have the 10 of Clubs here. This is called the Bear. The King of Hearts, love it. And the 9 of Diamonds, amazing. Almost every single sign has had the 9 of Diamonds as well. The 10 of Clubs is called the Bear, and it can represent overbearing energy or like heavy energy. To me, it's also a card of learning. Normally, there are 2 little baby bears with a mother bear on the bear card, and it can represent just learning, but it is a card of great progress. In the playing card reading system, the 10 of Clubs is actually a card of leaps and bounds of success. It's like making a huge leap in progress. The King of Hearts is your true love. And this is a card called the Home, and it represents someone who is like has the feelings of home, like safety, security, comfort, protection. And you have the 9 of Diamonds. Ooh, if this doesn't sum up your reading, I don't know what does. I mean, to me, the 9 of Diamonds says you are inside this coffin and you need to open this door. This card is called the Coffin. And it basically says, you're inside this coffin. debt, Ten of Swords, right? It is time to open the door and step into a new life. It is time to open up to something new. So I really feel like you need to realize that it's a new year and that there are new amazing things available to you at this time. So I do feel for some of you, it's like you're opening up to something new with this Nine of Diamonds energy. Definitely could be new love here for sure. The Five of Hearts in this deck is like called Cupid. So, you know, again, it's really just a playing card. To me, it just represents... normally represents jealousy and gossip in the playing card reading system. In this deck, it's like new love, and it is interesting. It comes up next to this Two of Cups. I feel like a lot of you have been having a lot of stinking thinking here, right here, with love, as far as love is concerned. But I feel like this could be someone who changes everything for you. I really feel like your words are going to be very important over the next 3 months, like speaking highly of yourself, telling yourself that you deserve something, all these things. Again, Six of Diamonds, a card of imposter syndrome, feeling like you're not good enough to have something when you are. So I feel like you need to embrace this energy, but this looks okay here, Taurus. So thank you for watching, really appreciate it. Make sure to watch your Sun, Moon, and Rising for a full picture of what's going on for you over these next 3 months. Also, make sure to like and subscribe. Really appreciate all the support. And I will see you in the next video.